Since last we spoke, you seem to have spent a lot of time on an aeroplane and visited a lot of countries. What have you been up to?
Oh, it's been a busy time in venture capital. I've been traveling around the world, visiting portfolio companies in Europe and Asia. Been to several countries in Europe, went to Pakistan, went to Jordan, and then obviously all over the US, we have companies coast to coast.
Is there any sort of thematic divide of what you invest in Europe vis-a-vis what you've invested in here in the United States? Is there sort of a distinct pool of talent there?
You know, generally, no. So as you said, we invest at the intersection of technology and sciences, solving hard problems and frankly, matter that matters. You know, while a lot of people in Silicon Valley might like to be thought leaders and think of themselves as visionaries, the reality is capital follows talent and talent follows interests. And the interest right now is in solving important, interesting problems. And that's where we're spending our time. So, you know, a couple of areas that emerge, frankly, globally for us to invest in. It is securing life and environment. So it is companies like SailDrone that are working on climate change and, you know, hurricane intensity and understanding weather patterns that affect globally and defense and national security. It is advancing and promoting, profitability and productivity. So companies like Applied Intuition, building autonomous cars and enabling transition to electric vehicles globally. We're working on enabling free expression. Democracy is very important. So companies like Hugging Face that are like sort of a global leader in the largest community of machine learning developers around the world, frankly, and the company's based in Europe, as you know, headquartered in Paris. And then...
Yeah, we had Clem, the CEO, on the show. Was it this week or last week, guys? I think it was last week, but they've just raised money as well. And what was interesting there is that they're going to use it for the talent because it's proving expensive. Just talk a little bit specifically about the Hugging Face investment.
I think, you know, machine learning AI revolution is happening globally, and I think it's happening with people. So this is not something that requires significant amounts of capital and deployment into CapEx, into hardware systems. But what's really happening is people around the world are developing solutions using AI that previously was simply not available or just too expensive to develop. And that is happening everything from, you know, fintech and traditional enterprise software all the way to solving healthcare problems and productivity and industrial solutions. So that's what Hugging Face is doing, is the largest community of machine learning developers and models literally all around the world. And the capital that they raise is to make sure that they invest in it.
Yeah, Clem DeLong on the show last week. The story for the firm this year has been that latest $1.15 billion fund for science, deep tech. In the time that that was announced back in April, I think, have you literally just been writing checks? How does it work mechanically when a firm raises new funds? Can you just go out there and start deploying?
Technically, yes. We start deploying capital when we raise it from the LPs. We have, obviously, this is our fund 8. We've been, you know, we have $5 billion under management. We've been deploying capital from previous funds as well. Our focus is going to continue to be to invest at the intersection of technology and sciences. And this could be physical sciences, everything from semiconductor chips to autonomy, automation, industrial automation. You saw the news about Apple using 3D printers, et cetera. It could be life sciences, you know, reducing human suffering, developing new drugs, and therapies, and it could be computer sciences, you know, machine learning, AI, cybersecurity, and preparing for defense, frankly.
An umbrella area of interest to myself, my colleague, Lizette Chapman, who's been writing about it, but also LPs, is defense. What do you see? Why is this now in vogue, for want of a better expression?
I don't know if it's in vogue. I think it's more importantly a realization that whether we like it or not, we are at some sort of a war. There is a war going on in Europe between Ukraine and Russia, and U.S. technologies from the private sector and the public sector have been very influential there. We are at odds with the CCP that have aggressive designs that is increasingly hostile towards the U.S. And the realization that the last 20 years of warfare were guerrilla warfare in the Middle East, going town to town, house to house. And now we're facing an extremely sophisticated enemy with digital tools, autonomous systems, AI-based solutions that are, frankly, pervasive in our lives and offensive from the CCP. They see that as a zero-sum game. So we have to prepare for that. We have to work for that. And I think the change that has happened is a realization that the old-school way of working through 5-6 large primes and developing technologies just doesn't work. You have to work with the private sector to bring new technologies in, whether it's drones, systems or detection systems. You know, SailDrone has hundreds of drones around the globe collecting data and analyzing data. This is what's needed for where the water is going. And hopefully we can actually reduce human suffering and reduce casualties in doing that, not putting humans in harm's way.